Hi, DerpyMoose99 here with episode 7 of series 2, Banished with Megamod 9. Now, just before we get into the meat of the episode here, I just wanted to talk about my derping around in the dock here. So I've gone back and loaded up some old saves, and I asked Grace a question too, which she was kind enough to answer. So these workshops here have these white connector parts. So when I look at why this wasn't working here, you see this connector at the far end. It's butted up against the storage here, the large storage. Now, when I went back and loaded up the last series, and even older game, because I keep a lot of old files around for some reason. But anyways, all the other times when I've used workshops in a row like this, the initial connection way up at the top here was against a dock segment, not against a building. So I've been doing this wrong, obviously my whole life, but I've been doing this wrong for a long time, particularly with the workshops and just getting away with it because... like I say, there wasn't a building between the dock connection and the workshop. So when I put these little 2x1s here, that connected it up. So it looks to me like, from a practical basis, you only have to connect one. And then as long as they're all connected together, you can see the sort of white lines going down there. Now, why the chicken coops were having a problem, I don't really know. Because they're actually connected over, and Grace, we'll call that a dock, okay? They're connected over to the stone dock over there. So I'm kind of thinking that the ones that were in trouble, there was homeless and toolless people in the chicken coops. I think they were probably from the workshops and they just wandered over there. Because of the other issues in this episode, I'm not going to remove this chunk of dock and experiment with that. And actually, while we're here, let's just add a few more chicken coops. Okay, now let's have a look at the situation I've put ourselves in here. So, and if you don't want to see a banished player panic, then I'd say look away for a little while. But if we look at our food graph, that's atrocious. So I was really, really, in fact, last episode at the start, I bragged about not killing anybody by starvation. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to keep my objective here. But that graph is bad. That's a pretty dire circumstance. So what I did is I distracted myself building all kinds of stuff, didn't pay attention to the food, and now we're in a huge jam. So I'm going to, at the start of this episode, I'm basically going to panic, find every food source we can, and also, let's have a look up here. Yeah, okay, so I was building a bunch of storage up here for the pastures and that, but there's storage at the bottom that's up and a couple here. Be adequate for generations to come. So I've put all that stuff on pause in case we want to build stuff. Now we still have a build queue of 64. So there's some rice farms going in there. There's some glass greenhouses going in there. And down here, if I pan back and select these fisheries here, oh, let's just check the first one for food here. 2568 last year, that's alright. Didn't mean to unselect. There we go. You can see the circles. So what I want to do is build this other wharf out, and then I'm going to take and put, you know, somewhere, say, there we'll put another fishery, and somewhere around, I don't know, there. So that'll take a while to build out, and I'll have to remember to keep coming down here and having a look. Okay. Now, just before we start doing any panicking here, well, actually, I'm already kind of panicked. Let's have a look, and I better write this down, too. We are at 464 people, and hopefully that goes up and not down. We are 100% clothed, 100% educated. We're at 4.5 hearts and 4.5 stars. Let's look at our inventory. We'll do it by quantity. Still tons of flowers. The fodder is actually going down a little bit. Perfume steady. Reeds are back up to almost 6,000. Linen clothing looks really strong. We have enough glass for a few greenhouses. And we have only 200 lumber, so I better turn one of those back on. Okay, nothing really leaps out at me there, other than the fact we don't have enough food. Okay, so what are we going to do here? Let's talk about steps. So we're going to turn on at least one of these sawmills. And if we want glass to keep producing, we better up this to say let's double it, 1600. And are you fully stocked? Yeah, you're fully staffed. And you are working with a limit of 600. That'll work. Okay, we have a little space here, so why don't we jam in? Yeah, let's put a food supplier right in there. Yeah, I'll tell you what, I don't want to distract builders, so I'm not going to build roads until we have, until we officially declare non-panic. But I am going to build a little storage there. You know what, I'll build storage there later too. So we'll just do the food supplier for now. Let's go into our general dock. And we have auto purchase is not set. Let's say 5,000 vegetables. And, I don't know, 3,000 fruit. And what does this have for inventory? Not very much. Okay, we better bulk that up. Okay, so we set this guy up for firewood, perfume, linen clothing, survival coats, and rope. I think that's the extent of our trade goods at the moment. And let's max that out. So there's not as many food suppliers, obviously, that come to this trading post. But in case any do, we're set up there. Okay, greenhouses. Okay, we need this to go away. Now, I think let's just plunk down. 8x12s aren't huge, but okay, so maybe if there's anything lucky about the food deer pier, we're in spring, so if we can find places where fields will build without construction. That might buy us some time. Yeah, I think that's a way to go. So let's find some places that we can build where we can immediately start planting. Okay, so let's put lentils, 2 people. You can be spinach, 1 person. You can be peanuts, 2 people. Okay, and back down here. Sweet potatoes, 1 person. Tomatoes, 1 person. Peas, 1 person. These guys are producing already. Okay, missed this one. So beans, 2 people. Now let's lay out some farms up here. Yeah, I was gonna do 15 by 15s. I tell you what, I'll just pause the video for a bit here while I lay out some fields and I'll come back. Okay, I've laid out 6 15 by 15 fields here and 6 houses. And I'm gonna give that a priority. Now, we're still not off pause yet because I want to find out what other ideas we can try here. Oh, I know something I wanted to check too was this dense tree shack. Let's see how it's doing. Hasn't produced anything yet because we're over the 1,000 limit on logs. But certainly is a dense forest in there. So let's try a little experiment here too. Just for the future, if we maybe wanted to style a different style of forest node. We have a tiny gatherer in here that does mini gather. Okay. That's about the same size circle. Why don't we put that there? Just as an experiment. We need the food anyways. But let's put a mini gatherer in there and see if it actually collects, or because the trees are so dense, there's no room for wild food to grow. Now let's go down here. Yeah, I might go back up and lay some more fields up above. But the other thing we can put in that should go pretty fast. If we go into the food and we go into hunting. Okay, these hunting blinds here, these little guys. Let's slam a bunch of these in around the docks here. Okay. That's going to end up being a total eyesore. So we'll go back and clean that up later. Okay, so we'll put a bunch of those in. Our build queue is now up to 136, which I think is awesome. So even if we wanted to do something else right now, I don't think it's going to build. Okay, and I'm pretty sure I prioritized this road removal so we can build more greenhouses. Okay, let's go back up to our pasture area. Yeah, okay, we're going to watch these when they come up, but new pastures won't produce for us immediately because we need the animals to grow. We only have 8 longhorn cattle. Yeah, we only have 8 longhorn cattle, and we have... Well, the chickens are about to hit the limit, so... So far, they're just eggs. Well, I'm just going to put a couple more fields in random places. Now, these will all have to be cleaned up later. Well, they don't have to be, but they're going to be atrocious to look at, so... And they'll also be a constant reminder of my shame at letting the food situation get like that. So I think the only thing left to do right now is, you know what? I'm going to save it just in case I have to save scum. Save scumming is not ideal, but hey, I'm not a proud person. Let's let it go. Okay, I want to watch this area in particular here. And sorry about the cluttered interface, but I want to make sure we can jump on any possible food production as soon as we can. Okay, they're clearing that road pretty good, actually. So let's get some greenhouses in there. Okay, constantly resisting the temptation to build a road and stuff. That'll have to be done later. Okay, let's go up and look at our forest, or not our forest, our food production area. Oh, small school on the dock. I forgot to pause that one, I guess. Okay, there is some planting going on in some of our panic fields here. Let's go down and look at the main city. Yeah, we should get a little bit of food at least out of those. Okay, early summer, probably won't get anything out of this one, but let's put it in anyways. Let's go peas. No, beans, I think. I can't remember what the fastest growing one Steve just told me, but I totally forgot. Sorry, man. Okay, some rice farms have come up. More interface clutter here, but we really need to jump on these as quickly as we can. Okay, now we're still going to assimilate the lake, so let's build over here. Panic situation, I'm going to build 3. And maybe throw some more rice farms on there if I can. Okay, how else can I add to the build queue? Probably should resist that for now, I would think. Okay, there's a trader. Okay, this was part of my discussion around the industry trade port versus the industry supplier. So this is the one that we set up last time. And okay, so far I've only seen one merchant to this one, but it's early days yet. So let's dismiss you. We do have auto purchase set up, don't we? Yep. I could probably back off on the log purchasing for now, but okay, I think maybe what we'll do here is I'll pause here, just skip ahead a little bit, and right now we're at 1,963 food, so we're about to die. Yeah, that's not good. Okay, and I forgot to build on the lake down here. Okay, but anyways, I think we'll pause here and skip forward a little bit. I'll see you in a minute. Hi there, we're back. And just to totally distract from the whole food panic thing, which I absolutely didn't cause, we have a trader with animals here. So what I would like to do is buy these red Friesen. We have a pasture that just came up, so... Oh, interesting, they do take perfume. Good deal. Okay, red Friesen. And just while we're here, let's up the perfume in here. That's good news. Let's make this 1,000. Okay, red Friesen. So let's go up to where we were building pastures. And one has built, so that's good news. Red Friesen. Now, this won't help us immediately, but it's cool. And I'm really thinking of getting into some dairy production once we get going here. So, a few farms... This is actually not skip forward all that far. It's early autumn now. Some farms have built. Some crops were laid in those panic farms. So, we're currently at 3366 for food. So, I'm thinking these dock fisheries which just kicked in. So, that one's on 2184 so far this year. And this one's 2340 so far this year. So I think those are helping save our butt, maybe. Plus, the first few episodes of this series, we laid in a pretty sound foundation. We have 4 gatherers, 4 hunters, and these greenhouses. Well, that production is down to 1,000, so I'm probably derping on the housing here. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, not super stoked to build more houses, but I think the benefits of having closer workers to these greenhouses, you know, versus the additional children and the growth. Because those greenhouses were pulling in a lot more than that before. Oops. Not sure if I borked that or not. Okay, so I'm going to let it run here. And let's just see if we break my number one objective. I called this series Second Chance, and the whole idea behind that was I wanted to get to 3,000 without having a major starvation die-off, or in fact killing anybody for lack of food. If people die here, it's going to be a major disappointment to me. Why don't we... Oh. You gotta turn it on first. Let's go beans again. Okay. So I talked about using this area for an experiment in the last episode. I was going to do 15 by 15s and 12 by 12s and all that. I just slammed in 15 by 15s here because it is panic mode. So what I might do in the way of an experiment here is we'll set the top ones for 3 farmers. But the farmers pick the food up. The bottom ones here. Now, if you remember that tool I showed you, it said 15 by 15s need 2 people. I'm going to put 2 people in the bottom ones instead of 3 like in the top. But I'm going to set these 3 bottom ones for laborer pickup. And then we'll kind of watch them. And I built 6 houses in the middle, which isn't enough for all of them. But, you know, we'll build a few more as we need them or as these come up. But that should give us a pretty good comparison between laborer pickup and 2 farmers versus 3 farmers only. I want to sort of use this to kind of play around a bit to figure out how to handle the situation when the town gets really large and your pathing gets kind of out of control. Okay, we have a trader coming in. Oh, bring food. A white mulberry. Okay. So if I didn't kill us all via starvation, we'd at least have white mulberry. All right, let's trade off some rope. And 90 left. That's 6 coats. Okay, we bought white mulberry. That's cool. Okay. I don't really want to build an orchard right now and distract, but good to know. How are we doing up here? Okay, another crop field. Now we're sitting, we're in autumn, so in theory, yeah, the harvests are starting to come in now. Now, unfortunately, there's not a lot of barns around here. Oh, there's a food supplier. Okay, let's set up the food supplier here. First of all, let's make sure we have the maximum number of traders. And what do we want here? We want to kind of really stuff this guy. So let's go 1200 firewood. And let's go 1200 perfume. 300 linen clothes. When I went through the inventory, there was a lot of those. And let's go 300 survival coats. Now I have to come back once this is filled up and see where we're sitting for capacity. I don't want to overfill this. Hard to buy stuff when you have a full warehouse. So this is set up with firewood, perfume, linen clothing, and survival coats. And I don't think we'll do auto purchase to start with. I want to be selective and make sure we get, you know, pick the cheapest food so we maximize what we get. Okay, farm supplier. Oh, that was the guy with the freezing cattle. You know what? Why don't we get trade pigs too? Can we buy all those? Let's see. Let's trade additional 4 units. Okay, trade pigs. So this is the first time I've tried trade animals, so we're really gonna have to see how this works. Okay, this pasture's almost ready to come up, but let's put them in our temporary holding pen down here. Trade pigs in one. Oop, gotta turn it on. And we're out of laborers. That's probably not ideal. Okay, 26 builders for 142 production or build queue and 10 laborers. Okay, food is just gone over 5,000. Now, if we can get the next harvest, I'd say we might have avoided the major pain here. Man, I'm mad at myself for totally forgetting about food. You know, like, I watch other people stream and YouTube Banished, and I know what it's like to sit there and watch somebody make a major mistake and not see it. Okay, we got a boat here. White mulberry again. Oh no, we just didn't release you. Derp. And you can go away. Now, I think for priorities right now, we should be doing stuff that does year-round production. So let's prioritize the ducks, the greenhouses, and the rice. Because looking at the rice planters here, the laborers have brought all the material. We just need to build them. Okay, I think it might be a good time to pause for a little bit and come back to some of the more of this stuff is built. Okay, so we're back. Just skipped a little bit ahead to spring here. We are at 7,917 food. And we have our first merchant come to our food supplier here. Now, we haven't got a lot of stuff, but there's 1,105 firewood. So let's go max on that. So 4,420. We're going to buy 2,000 carrots, and we have lentils there, so 2420 on the lentils. Okay, and hopefully they bring the rest of the trade goods for the next one. More seeds. I don't know if we have cherry yet. Let's have a look here. You know, that might be another fun objective too, is try and buy one of everything so we fill out this screen. Never done that before. I don't see cherry. So let's buy cherry. Okay, let's do a quick state of the nations. I'm focused on food right now, but let's make sure we have everything else under control. Tools look good, coats look good. Now we're trading a lot of stuff, so that's why the coats have gone down a bit. We have over 2,000 stone and we have 7,000 logs, which is probably excessive even for me. So instead of 2,000, let's call this 800. And here, yeah. So looking at our lake down here, we're building out every time I get down here, I add a few more on here. So let's have a look at how our fisheries did. Holy shimoly, 4,008 fish last year. I don't believe I've ever seen it that high before for one of those. So maybe putting these two dock homes, which was a total experiment, right beside the fishing dock actually helps rather than hurts. Okay, let's have a look at our other one, the embarrassing one that I put the houses one spot back. 3,996. So 4,000 food from four people. You know what? These next two, I'm going to call these fishing nodes instead of forest nodes, but these next two fishing nodes, I'm going to build them with the houses actually outside the circles. I'm still going to have the storage inside. You know, maybe I can do one each way. So let's go full experimental here and see actually what the best setup is. Okay, stop nerding out on fishing. Okay, let's have a look up here. Okay, we're in late spring, so yeah, I'm going to prioritize this anyways. Okay, and okay, what's happened here? Okay, a bunch of our chicken coops have come up, and some of these duck blinds or hunting blinds have come up as well too. Now we're starting to run low on people, but I'm going to keep pumping these up until we run out of people, basically. Okay, that was too many of those. So that was derping around there. I'm looking at these question marks pumping up the dock workers, but those are actually hunters. Okay, do we have any question mark people? No. Okay. So what are we down for? Yeah. Let's equal that out. So we have five laborers and five builders. Haven't been that low for a long time. So the stuff that's laid out to be built is not going to be built anytime soon. Where are we in housing? Yeah, okay, so we're 16 behind on housing. You know what? I'm not going to declare the food panic over, but we're going to need more people here. And the food is sort of recovering. I mean, 8,000 fish per year down here, like, my God. I think we're going to build more houses. So we said 16. Now there's five there. And there's four going in there. Well, you know what? We almost have 16 in progress, so let's just let this rip. Okay, let's see what the trader wants or has. Yeah, no, I don't think we need to buy anything from there now. We have a bunch of mulberry leaf in stock if we ever decide to build the eggs, so. And we've got the white mulberries now. I wonder if we can risk it and put in an orchard for those. Okay, that's the same trader as before, so still only one. One merchant has showed up to this guy. Okay, there's another crop field. This one is lentils, so a few peas. Yeah, the other variable here is the crop type, where they have different characteristics, which I'd actually forgotten about. I should do a little more reading on that and figure out, if you're going to go into panic mode, what's the fastest growing, fastest harvesting? I don't think the variations are huge, but there is variations. Okay, let's have a look at our chickens. Oh, we're getting chicken meat now. Good. And feathers and fertilizer. I still think that's cute calling that fertilizer. I guess technically it is. Okay, we got some storage coming up that'll help with the harvest. Gotta stop looking at that one. It's all set up already. Beef food. Cool. Okay. This isn't filling up very fast with five workers. Probably big competition around grabbing the coats here. Okay, what do we got? 67.84. Oh, bacon. How can you say no to bacon? Guava. Some milk. Kale. If I got that. Oh, and bacon and egg, I wonder. Yeah, I'm going to check that later and see if it actually gets consumed. All right, there's maxed out. Let's go down to our lake here. Build a little bit more. I think soon we can start building out to this guy. Okay, let's have a look up here. No more hunters. So these little hunting blinds here, you know, that one's only producing feathers so far. I've had mixed results with these in the past, so Yeah, 200 duck meat for one person. They just went in. We'll keep an eye on those, whether we want to keep those around or not, but definitely some of them are going to be blocking access, so have to clean all that up. So again, I think let's just prioritize the greenhouses. And seeds. Yeah, I think we'll just pass for now. Their firewood. I haven't really built any more firewood lately, so might, once the panic's over, might think about building a few more sawmills. Okay, there's a greenhouse. Now we have beans, so let's do that. Another greenhouse. Let's make this blueberries. Okay, you are in the bean row. And the last row we're gonna make, why don't we make oats? Why do you have water in there? Blueberries. Oh, these use water. Duh. I wonder how we're doing on water down here. We only have. Yeah, I derp out again. I don't actually have water production down here. Now, these guys use water. And let's just check these boats before I figure that out. You've got glass and lumber. How are we doing for glass here? Okay, sort by name. Glass is 84. And but the last one of our greenhouses to be built here has already got its glass, so I think we'll pass for now. We're making it. And lumber we've got enough of, so you can go away. And same merchant again. Okay. So let's go up to our forest home here. Now we have three water tanks here. Another one that I decided to put in. Let's see where we're at on water. 156. Oh, we have, wow, we have 24,379 food. Be way too early, but I'm declaring panic is over. Once those rest of those 15 by 15 fields build, I'm gonna go back and delete all the panic built ones. Okay, where was I going? Water. Okay. Now I should have water production down here. And there's a space here where we can't put greenhouses. So I'm gonna see. Let's stay with the. Oh, that works out. Okay, we'll put four water towers in there. And they'll go in the water will go in these general food warehouses, so that'll work out. Now, probably with all these hunters here, let's put some specialty food in our storage. So let's put a meat locker. Oh, I don't know. Kind of ugly, but we'll just put a meat locker there. And we have some more ducks and stuff down here, duck hunters. So let's put a meat locker in right there. Okay, and at the end of the rice row here, I put a couple of general grain warehouses. So of course our build queue, well, it's down to seven. Build queue's down to 71. That's not terrible. Let's go 10 builders and 8 laborers. Okay, so I think maybe we'll pause again for a little bit and see where we're at, but. And I hope it's not premature, but I'm definitely declaring the food panic over. So once all this stuff builds, we'll get back to our regular planning and building and Borg assimilation of the lake. So we'll see in a bit. Okay, let's do a state of the nation here, see where we're at. Our food graph is looking like that. So there was the big dip, and now we're back up again. Let's have a quick look at tools. Tools is fine. Firewood will be up and down. So the main one is the food. So happy with that. So we're now at 540 people, and we started the episode with 464. So we've actually grown. Okay, let's have a look around here. So I've removed all the temporary fields, taken out some little barns here. Our greenhouse is all built, all our little hunters built. There's a couple hunters here I built right in, sort of in the future access to these dock sections here, so I've taken those out or in the process. We've removed all the fields up here. Now some crops grew and sort of stayed behind here, so that's going to be picked up. 15 by 15s have built. So again, these ones here at the top are three farmers. and they're doing farmer pickup. These are two farmers and they're doing laborer pickup. So it won't be fair to compare these until another year goes by because some of these came in at various times. But I've also built a little bit of a farming community here. We're getting fairly far away from our school and our market here. So there is a cool looking little school here. And there's something called a tiny market here where we've got two people working. So I'm going to continue building out to the left here and we'll put another large central market at some point. So we've got two orchards going in for now. So I'm going to make those white mulberry if our food situation is okay. We have another pasture available. Our chickens have been producing quite a bit here, so yeah. So that's, you know, over 1,000 food. Well, let's look at last year. Wow, that's actually 1,800 food for two people working it. I'm pleased with that. This is our red friesians. We have 17. Our longhorns, we have 24, and we have a spare pasture. So I think we'll start building out the pastures. And let's have a look at our lake down here. Okay, so we have one fish dock that's being built. And we can just throw in the... So this one continues sort of in the vein of experimentation here. I'll put the storage inside the circle, but I will put the houses outside the circle. Oops, did I put that in the wrong spot? I should derp around off camera. Anyways, I'll do that later. I think actually what I'm going to do here is I'm going to bring this episode to an end because that was mostly about food panicking. And what I'd like to do is end the episode here, spend a little bit of time planning out the next steps and come back in the next episode with a more planned, thoughtful, and mature approach rather than the blind panic that I had in the last episode. So I'm really, really going to try and keep an eye on that food. So right now we're at 36,700 food. I showed you the graph, it's going up. Yeah, I haven't yet starved anybody to death, but that came really close, I think. Oh, so one thing I did notice with us building out to the left here on the farming community, we now have people wandering up and down through the woods here. So we're going to have to lay in a road there. And maybe even a halfway house for people. Okay, let's see what this boat is all about. Oh, sheepy sheep. Ah, let's get the sheepy sheep before we go here. 4,800. So if I can do math, that should be 600 perfume. Oh, you know what? Oh, we have our trade pigs and our temporary duck. That was a little bit of a derp. You know what? Let's leave the trade pigs in the temporary pasture. And let's put the sheepy sheep in here. Okay, so now we have sheep, longhorn cows, friesian cows, and chickens. And I'm going to play around with a bit and see what a model would look like to expand this. Because I want to sort of keep doing this where we have... Now, it'll be smaller because the pastures only need two workers. But, you know, where we have a school and a market with some distributed housing. So, you know, large central location, smaller distributed rural communities is what I'm trying to say. I think I definitely want to end the episode here. Do some planning and I'll come back in episode 8 in a little better fashion. That was episode 7 of series 2 of Banished with Megamod 9, and I am Derpy Moose 99. Thank you very much.